Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to turn the microphone over to Tech Sergeant Brian Pontus and the A-10 Thunderbolt 2. Hi, guys.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the United States Air Force, the commander of Air Combat Command, General Mark Kelly, and all the men and women of Air Combat Command, we welcome you to the 2020 Naval Air Station Air Show at Oceana. I am the A-10 Demo Team Superintendent, Master Drew Rehnquist from Fergus Falls, Minnesota. Joining me is our safety officer and combat-ready attack pilot, Captain Sky Lesh, call sign Comet, from Charlotte, North Carolina. As a member of Air Combat Command's 355th Wing, located at Davis Monthan Air Force Base in Tucson, Arizona, it is my distinct pleasure to describe to you a capability demonstration by the heavily armed and armored close air support aircraft, the A-10 Thunderbolt 2. Our mission is to provide the close air support needed for our Army, Marine, and all Allied ground forces so they can operate anywhere, anytime. Since 9/11, the United States Air Force has provided over 900,000 air missions in support of today's joint fight. The A-10 demonstration pilot is Major Cody Wilton, call sign Shiv, from Mineral Wells, Texas. Major Wilton enlisted in the Air Force in 2001 as an airborne linguist. Since commissioning in 2009, Major Wilton has become a veteran instructor pilot with more than 1,700 hours in the A-10, including 87 combat missions supporting coalition ground forces in the skies of Afghanistan for Operation Enduring Freedom. Assisting in today's demonstration are Tech Sergeant Brian Pontes from San Leandro, California, Staff Sergeant Sean Mabry from Shreveport, Louisiana, Senior Airman Hunter Nance from Gadsden, Alabama, and Airman First Class Nolan Foster from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. And also joining us from Public Affairs is Senior Airman Christine Legate from Surprise, Arizona. The A-10 is capable from operating for much shorter runways than the conventional fighter attack aircraft. Major Wilton demonstrated that capability today when he lifted off at only 1,500 feet. In fact, with 16,000-pound bomb load, A-10s can still take off in less than 4,000 feet. On this aircraft, you will notice a heritage paint scheme inspired by the Hun Hunter of Texas, a World War II P-51 Mustang piloted by Captain Henry Brown, the highest scoring ace for the 355th Fighter Group. Because of its toughness, tenacity, and devastating good looks, the people who know it best, the pilots who fly it, and mechanics who maintain it, have unofficially dubbed it the Warthog. Air Combat Command, Pacific Air Forces, the Air National Guard, and the Air Force Reserves all fly the A-10. Ladies and gentlemen, look to your right, Major Wilton in the A-10 Thunderbolt 2. Watch now as Major Wilton pulls the A-10 straight into the vertical, demonstrating the Warthog's power and maneuverability in all attitudes of flight. Major Wilton is now positioning the A-10 for a pass down the show line, where he will perform a double aileron roll. During this maneuver, he will demonstrate the Hog's rapid roll capability by rolling his aircraft at 200 degrees per second. And now, from the left, Major Wilton displaying the Warthog's rolling maneuverability. Demonstrate the Hog's precise handling characteristics. As he rolls, you will notice a fake canopy painted on the belly of the aircraft. This false canopy is designed to deceive enemy ground troops while concealing a titanium armor barrier that protects the pilot from enemy ground fire. And now, from the right, the slow roll. Major Wilton is now performing a classic aerobatic maneuver, the Q8. It's the A-10's remarkable maneuverability that enables it to perform its close air support mission. Twisting and turning low over the battlefield, the Warthog can deliver devastating firepower, destroying targets in close proximity to friendly ground forces. The A-10's two TF-34 turbofan engines add more than just power to its performance. They're much quieter than comparable engines. This makes the airplane much harder to hear and aids immensely in achieving tactical surprise. The Hog's engines are also extremely fuel efficient, enabling it to fly more than 1,000 miles without refueling. Add an in-flight refueling and the Warthog can fly nonstop to Europe, the Pacific, and the Middle East. Major Wilton is now repositioning his aircraft to perform a level 360 high G turn. It's the A-10's quick turn rate and small turn radius, which enable it to work effectively over the battlefield, even under marginal weather conditions. Turn in only 1,400 feet. This is less than the size of an average NASCAR racetrack at well over twice the speed of any driver. On the battlefield, this capability enables the Warthog to turn quickly and evade enemy air defenses. Major Wilton is now configuring his aircraft to demonstrate the A-10's slow speed controllability. At its final approach speed of 120 knots, this slow speed pass will give you a good chance to see the A-10's high bypass engines in unique tail design. These distinct features help mask the engine heat signature, aiding the pilot to defeat infrared missiles. Let's go to the cockpit of the A-10 and hear what Major Wilton has to say.
A-10 Demo Team, we'd just like to thank NAS, Oceana, and their crew for hosting this great live event and all you fans who have tuned in to watch us today. Thanks for coming out. Thanks for watching us.
Is the premier close air support aircraft supporting our ground forces engaged with the enemy. These forces usually include a Air Force Joint Terminal Attack Controller, or JTAC, embedded in the unit. The JTAC coordinates and controls the A-10 to engage the enemy. Low altitude tactical navigation is a core competency of every A-10 pilot. The ability to utilize terrain masking techniques in a high-threat environment allows today's attack pilot to surprise unsuspecting targets using the A-10's weapon of choice, the awesome Gatling Avenger 30mm Gatling gun. Firing at 70 rounds per second, its big shell delivers 7 times the destructive energy than the more conventional 20mm round. Listen now as Major Wilton obtains final attack clearance from the JTAC.
Hog 1, up and in.
Hog 1, continue. Hog 1, cleared hot.
Hog
It will now take Major Wolf less than 30 seconds to get back into firing position. With two hogs working together, enemy forces could be under A-10 fire once every 10 to 15 seconds. Now repositioning for his final attack. Will he simulate dropping 500-pound bombs? These general-purpose bombs are useful for creating airfields or destroying buildings, adding versatility to the Hog's arsenal of weapons. Now performing a jink-out maneuver. This continuous changing, three-dimensional maneuver makes it very difficult for enemy anti-aircraft gunners to track the A-10. The Warthog was built to withstand significant battle damage, while having the capability to fly on a single engine and total loss of hydraulic power. The Warthog has a well-earned reputation for strength and striking power, a reputation earned in multiple deployments, where Hogs destroyed numerous enemy armored vehicles, artillery sites, Scud missiles, and was even credited with two air-to-air kills. Today, the upgraded A-10C continues to set the standard for supporting Allied forces in today's fight. Now, from the right, Major Wilton in a four-point roll, displaying the crisp handling characteristics of the A-10.
Ladies and gentlemen, Major Wilton is now repositioning his A-10 for the dedication pass.
We would like to dedicate this pass to the men and women of the armed forces and their families.
We would also like to remember our wounded warriors and veterans in attendance today.
Finally, remember those who have given their lives defending our great nation.
From behind and to your right, A-10 Demo proudly presents the dedication pass. Once again, we salute those, all those fighting today's joint fight, and any wounded warriors and veterans in attendance today. We especially want to thank those who have given their lives in defense of this great country and all their families, which have sacrificed so much. The United States Air Force's Air Combat Command provides essential combat air support capability for today's joint fight. The A-10 has consistently demonstrated its ability to fly more than four sorties per day, a tribute to the skill and dedication of our magnificent maintenance crews. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a hand to our standing maintainers and all those service members keeping our aircraft fit to fight. We hope you have enjoyed this brief display of only a fraction of the A-10's full combat capability. As an integral part of the most capable Air Force the world has ever known, your A-10 Warthogs are ready to defend our nation's skies and dominate the battle space anywhere on the globe, ready to aim high, fly, fight, and win.
Thanks very much, Drew Rehnquist.